Okay, so today we are going to start analysis of pre-stressed concrete member by using strength concept. Now first you have to understand what is this new thing, strength concept. Okay, so see here, this is a typical beam which I have placed on a ground. Okay, and in this beam we have provided the tendon, and tendon we have stressed with the force, pre-stressing force P. Okay, when you have cut the tendon, that force is a reverse direction. In reverse direction, it's going to act on a tendon like this. Okay, and this tendon is placed with some eccentricity E. Now, main thing here, when pre-stressing force is here, and beam is laid on the ground, and if beam don't have any external bending moment, external load, so beam is not going to bend. Are you getting my point? सिंपल बीम है जर ग्राउंड बेंडिंग मोड येणार आहे का? एक्सटर्नल लोड जर झिरो असेल याच्यावर बीम वर, तर लोडिंग कमी असेल तर बेंडिंग मोड याच्यामध्ये येणार नाही. ओके, सो हियर द लाईन ऑफ ऍक्शन ऑफ लोडिंग ऑन दिस टेंडन, दॅट लाईन वी आर गोइंग टू कॉल्ड एज अ पी लाईन. ही जी फोर्स लाईन आहे ना, या टेंडनच्या लाईनला आपण काय म्हणतोय, फोर्स लाईन. हियर इन दिस कन्सेप्ट the p force acting on the tendon is separate. Jar kadla tar tumhala asa disel yacha madhe. Okay, next you can see figure number 2. Just I am shown here tendon and with the pre-stressing force p, so you can call this p force as a p line in the strength concept. Okay, now you can see this line, c force acting on the tendon. What happen now when beam is subjected with the loading here? When beam is subjected to the loading without any external load, this P line and C line are going to coincide to each other. Getting the point? The line of action of the tendon, each line of tendon chi, hela line man, ya line la kay manaycha? P line. P line is indicating that force line which is going to act on the tendon. That's a tendon separate dakhavla yachyamadhye. And second line of action, that line action is called as a C line. What is C line? C line means the concrete line where the stresses in concrete we are going to calculate. That line is called as a C line. आता बघा, मला तुम्ही एक याच्यामध्ये हे करा, जर याच्यामध्ये हा जर बीम ग्राउंडर नसला असता, याच्यावर एक्सटर्नल लोडिंग असले असते याच्यामध्ये. सपोज दिस बीम were not placed on ground, and suppose this beam is subjected with some movement, like this. No, so there is a no external loading, so concrete stresses are going to remain same. So P line and C line is going to coincide to each other. And what is C line means? Concrete line. Okay, the C force, which is the compressive force acting on the concrete, stresses in the concrete are produced entirely due to the C line. जे concrete मध्ये जे stresses develop होणार आहेत, आता जर external load नसेल याच्यावर, तर concrete as it is असंच राहणार आहे. फक्त ही line P line येणार आहे याच्यामध्ये. So P line and C line is going to coincide to each other. But the moment when you people are going to place loading on the beam, when beam is not going to placed on the ground, that case madhe ka anra yacha madhe, the beam is going to bend. Beam ya side la bend honar. Ani ji stress line ahe concrete chi, the concrete stress line is going to show different line. Je the concrete line tumhala ashi disel, an tya line la kay mhanto apan, C line. That line is called as a C line. Okay, kala sagana farak yacha madla, what is C line and what is P line? C line is called as a C force, you can like called as a C force also. That force is we are going to consider due to the concrete. Concrete madle je stresses tayar hota, tyachyamule jo tayar honara force hai, tyala apan C force mhantoy, and this is due to the concrete, due to the stresses of the concrete. And what is P line on P force? P force is due to the tendon. pre-stressing force. This is called as a this tendon. We are going to call it as a fibrous. They want to call it as a tendon force. Okay, so that's why we are going to call it as a, this is P force and this is C force or P line or C line. Now, what happens when bending moment is going to act on a beam? Earlier, we have seen without external loading, P line and C line are going to coincide to each other. ये दोनों ना एकमेकने कहते हैं coincide वाले तय लगता है। जरिये जब external loading नसील पर, but when the moment you are going to place the loading on the beam, जरिये जब तुम्ही loading के लार, तब P line अने C line दोनी एकमेकने separate वाला वक्त है। This is P line and here this is C line. P line and C line and the distance between the P line and C line we are going to call as a A and that is called as a shift of P line from the C line from the P line. The tendon cha line pasun je concrete force chi line hai ti force chi line var jayla bagte and tya dogan madla je distance hai tya distance la kya mhanto apan shift mhanto. The shift is called as a A and how we are going to calculate that shift A we are going to call by just you people know that eccentricity means what? P into E is equal to M. Okay, so similar for formula we have used, instead of calling it is eccentricity here we are going to call we are going to say as it is shift. So this is A, so A is equal to M by P. So if you know the total moment on the beam due to external load and pre-stressing force, you will get this distance A, shift of C line and P line. Okay, and then extreme stresses, how we are going to calculate? As usual, pre-stressing force, sorry, for direct stress we are going to calculate by considering C by A, or you can take this as a P by A also. Okay, and then plus minus C into E. Here eccentricity you are going to consider, and eccentricity is distance from that C line. Okay, what is eccentricity? Eccentricity of C line. So from centered axis we are going to see the C line, and C line cha apla eccentricity bagayche. Okay, so that eccentricity we have to calculate, and then as usual you are going to put, you are going to calculate the stresses. So what is new thing here? You have to identify where is the C line, where is the P line, whether they have given the shift or not. That shift you have to calculate, and by getting the shift you are going to calculate the eccentricity. Okay, and by putting the value of eccentricity here, eccentricity, you are going to get the moment. Kaya chama the query doubt kuna lai chama the. स्ट्रेंथ कॉन्सेप्ट मध्ये प्रॉब्लेम तुम्हाला काय क्वेरी आहे याच्यामध्ये काय क्वेरी असेल वेदर यू अंडरस्टूड ऑर नॉट लेट मी नो. कुणाला कळालं नसेल तर परत रिपीट करतो मी, पण काय कळालं नाही तेही सांगा मला. ओके, सगळ्यांना समजलं? सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट आहे, कुठल्याही बीम मध्ये त्याच्या ऍक्शन जे लोडिंग ऍक्शन आहे त्याच्यामुळे स्ट्रेसेस डेव्हलप होणार आहेत, त्या दोन गोष्टीमुळे होतात प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग बीम मध्ये. एक तर आहे टेंडन, बरोबर ना, स्ट्रेसेस डेव्हलप. जर तुम्ही स्ट्रेस कन्सिडर केला, ह्याच्यात दोन मटेरियल युज करतोय आपण, एक तर आहे स्टील टेंडनच्या फॉर्म मध्ये आणि दुसरा आहे कॉन्क्रीट. त्या दोघांचे लोडिंग ऍक्शन असणार. जर मी बीम एक प्लेन ग्राउंडवर ठेवला बीम आणि प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग फोर्स फक्त अप्लाय केला याच्यामध्ये, तर याच्यामध्ये प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग फोर्स नी स्ट्रेस येणार आहे. ओके, पण कॉन्क्रीटमुळे काय होत नाही, कारण कॉन्क्रीट बेंड होत नाही, आणि कॉन्क्रीट बेंड होत नसल्यामुळे काय याच्यामध्ये स्ट्रेसेस होणार नाही. त्याच्यामुळे कॉन्क्रीटची ऍक्शन लाईन स्ट्रेसेस आणि स्टीलचे स्ट्रेसेस हे दोन्ही काय एकमेकाला कॉन्साइड होणार आहे, कारण याच्यामध्ये ऍक्शनच नाही, बीमचे बीम बेंडच होत नाही, त्याच्यामुळे दोन्ही एकच लाईन राहणार. पण द मुवमेंट वेन यू आर गोइंग टू अप्लाय द लोड ऑन द बीम, आणि तर समजा जमिनीवर बीम नाही, तुम्ही विदाऊट ग्राउंड फ्लोअरला तुम्ही कन्स्ट्रक्ट केला, त्या केस मध्ये देर आर चान्सेस ऑफ बेंडिंग ऑफ बीम आणि त्या केस मध्ये ही सी लाईन येणार पिक्चर मध्ये. सी लाईन म्हणजे कळालं सगळ्यांना काय? सी म्हणजे स्ट्रेसेस ड्यू टू कॉन्क्रीट, म्हणजे या दोन्ही मध्ये या बीम मध्ये जे कॉन्क्रीट आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये स्ट्रेसेस डेव्हलप होणार आणि त्याची जी लाईन दाखवणार आहे स्ट्रेस लाईन त्या लाईनला काय म्हणतात? सी लाईन. आणि जेव्हा तुम्ही बीम मध्ये लोडिंग लावताय कॉम्बिनेशन टेंडन आणि कॉन्क्रीट मध्ये त्या केस मध्ये काय होणार आहे? कॉन्क्रीटचे स्टीलचे स्ट्रेस लाईन वेगळे असणार आहे आणि कॉन्क्रीटचे वेगळे असणार आहे. तर दोघांचं जे डिस्टन्स आपल्याला काढायचं आहे सी लाईन आणि पी लाईन यांचं लोकेशन आपल्याला फाइंड करायचं असेल, सो वी कॅन फाइंड आउट दॅट लोकेशन बाय कॅल्क्युलेटिंग द शिफ्ट. अँड हाऊ वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट द शिफ्ट? सो बाय युझिंग दिस फॉर्म्युला एम बाय पी, दॅट मुवमेंट ऑन टोटल बीम अँड द प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग फोर्स, वी आर गोइंग टू गेट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ ए. ही जर आपल्याला ए शिफ्ट मिळाला देन वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट इसेंट्रिसिटी. इसेंट्रिसिटी आपल्याला कॅल्क्युलेट करायची आणि ती इसेंट्रिसिटी आपल्याला या फॉर्म्युलामध्ये पुट करायची आहे. फक्त फॉर्म्युला तर सेम आहे, ते पी बाय ए सीच्या वेळी पी म्हणलं तरी चालेल. पी बाय डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेसेस प्लस मायनस, प्लस म्हणजे टॉप साईडला कॉम्प्रेशन आहे बेंड असं झालं, आपण असं कन्सिडर केलं बेंडिंग अशी कन्सिडर केली याच्यामध्ये. तर टॉपला कॉम्प्रेशन बॉटमला टेन्शन, सो इथं कॉम्प्रेशन टेन्शन आणि इथं काय करायचं तुम्हाला पी इंटू ई, हे इसेंट्रिसिटी तुम्हाला काय घ्यायचे? इसेंट्रिसिटी ऑफ लाईन, नॉट वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू कन्सिडर इसेंट्रिसिटी ऑफ पी लाईन, या पी लाईनची घ्यायची ना आपल्याला इसेंट्रिसिटी. We are going to consider the eccentricity of C line. And tumhala te ghetlyanantar we are going to get the stresses. And this is how you are going to calculate the stresses by using strength concept. Kaisha madhe doubt asel tar vichara mala. If you people have any query, doubt, let me know. नाही डाऊट कुणाल, सो वी कॅन स्टार्ट टू द प्रॉब्लेम नाउ. वेदर आय एम ऑडिबल फर्स्ट, तेवढं तर सांगा, बोलू नका बाकी, अभ्यास तर बोलू नका, फक्त सांगा आवाज ऐकवते का नाही ते. हॅलो
ऑडिबल सर?
येस सर.
तेवढं तर सांगा बाबा, बोला फक्त. ओके, सी वन प्रॉब्लेम नाउ. A prestress concrete beam 400 by 600 section, as usual what section we have taken. In section has a 7 meter span and subjected to the UDL of 18 kN meter. Include a self-weight of beam, which is the self-weight of beam they have considered. The prestressing tendon, which are located along longitudinal centroid axis, provide an effective prestressing force of 1200 kN. Determine the extreme stresses in the concrete for mid-span section. So we have to calculate the stresses here at mid-span section. Okay, so first thing, the as usual data required for solving the beam. So cross section area of the beam 400 by 600, so this is 2.4 × 10⁵. Section modulus, this is rectangle section, so bd square by 6, so this value come 2.4 × 10⁷ mm cube. Maximum bending moment, simply supported beam w square by 8, external load they have given 18. So as usual we are going to consider this load. Span is a 7 meter, so WL square by 8, this is 110.25 kN meter. Now main thing we have to calculate shift of C line from P line. Already I have told the formula how you are going to get the shift. So shift A is equal to M by P, moment divided by prestressing force. So here moment we have calculated 110.25, we have to convert into Newton mm, so that value 10⁶. And divided by P is a prestressing force. So prestressing force they have given 1200 kN in Newton. So that's why 10�³. So that shift we have got, that A value we have got 91.88. Means the C line and P line shift from each other at a distance of 91.88. म्हणजे या केस मध्ये या P line पासून C line जी आली आहे ती किती आहे? 91.88. 91.88. But which thing is required here? See, we have got a value here. Now next thing, eccentricity of C line. What is eccentricity of C line? That we have to calculate. So how we are going to get the eccentricity of C line? आता हे जे आपल्याला मिळालं 91.88, हे काय मिळालं मला सांगा? 91.88 this we have got shift kudla shift p line pasun te c line parinche distance we have got now we want the eccentricity of c line kay ala paye eccentricity of c line as a tendon is placed at longitudinal axis id kay kele tendon maide id tendon eccentricity nahi tendon kutu provide kele they have provided tendon at central axis mhanje tendon idhe sa tendon idhe sa तर या एक्सिस पासून या एक्सिस पर्यंत म्हणजे पी लाइन आणि सी लाइन पी लाइन सेंट्रोइडलाच आहे बघा म्हणजे टेंडन सेंट्रोइडलाच प्रोवाइड केलंय आपल्याला काय करायचं इसेंट्रिसिटी म्हणजे काय सेंट्रोइडल एक्सिस पासून ते सी लाइन पर्यंतचं डिस्टन्स ते म्हणजे इसेंट्रिसिटी सी लाइन इथे टेंडन इथे सेंटरला प्रोवाइड केलेलं आणि आपण शिफ्ट काढलं हे शिफ्ट इथे ए काढलं हे आपण याच्यामध्ये तर या केस मध्ये काय शिफ्ट ए इज इक्वल टू इसेंट्रिसिटी जी ए इथे कशाला इक्वल आहे eccentricity is equal hai so we are going to consider whatever shift is equal to the eccentricity so a is equal to e here so direct stress after getting this value we are going to calculate direct stress so direct stress here p by a or c by a so here by putting the value of compression for the pre-stressing force and the area so direct stress is 5 newton per mm square and extreme stress due to the bending moment so here p into eccentricity value you have to put So pre-stressing force into eccentricity we have calculated 91.88 divided by 2.4 into 10 to 7. So this value is plus minus 4.59. Okay. So this value final pre-stressing force here. Direct stressing we have calculated 5, and due to bending moment, bending stresses is plus 4.59 at top. So this value is 9.59 newton per mm square. A similar way we have calculated the stresses at bottom fiber. So this is direct stress plus. And minus is a bending stress because it is at bottom side, so that is in tension. So plus 5 minus 4.59, so that is plus 0.941 newton per mm square. And after putting, so do not consider this. So after putting the value here, c by a 5 newton per mm square, tendon is placed here, not here. Okay, do not consider this. Tendon is placed at longitudinal axis. So after putting this, okay, in the diagram picture form, you can see direct stresses and bending stresses. Addition of the all bending stresses, a direct stress and bending stress at top will be plus 9.59, and at bottom that is 0.41. So this is how we are going to calculate the stresses by using strength concept. Simple thing here. Only new thing here, you have to calculate the eccentricity. To get the value of eccentricity, you have to calculate the shift. How to calculate the shift? So by using simple formula, we are going to calculate the shift. Kal yachyamadhye kay doubt kunala? Let me know.